My name is Amberdawn Sese, and I am a director, I am a writer, I am a VFX editor, but most importantly, I'm a filmmaker. I'm a filmmaker in a sense where I want to make films that inspire people. I want to make films that mean something to people. I want to show the world who I am through my filmmaking, and I want to also show other people the way that they can do the same. And Colourless is just that. Colourless is a horror thriller and drama with a little bit of supernatural short film. And it is about a monochromatic colorblind artist named Macy who slowly loses herself in her black and white world through haunting dreams and visions that start to bleed into her reality. It is when she inflicts vengeance on those who wrong her that she finally starts to see color. So Colourless focuses on human emotions and what these emotions can lead to. It's a character study on most of these dark emotions that we dare not to speak. Macy lets her cynistic worldview take over and become her ultimate downfall as a character, letting jealousy, greed, and wrath control her. These themes are portrayed by characters in the film. Cynicism is represented by Macy, and due to her colorblindness, it's the way she views her black and white world. Cora represents envy and jealousy, as she is the contrast and the juxtaposition of Macy, being everything that she's not, physically, mentally, emotionally, etc. Lastly, Eric represents desire and greed, as his possible affair with Cora becomes a desire he craves, as well as a desire to move on from causing Macy's colorblindness. All these characters portray these themes and emotions being the ultimate downfall for these characters. For the AORL treatment, I imagine something along the lines of more synthesized cinematic motifs and themes rather than the music going all the way throughout the short film. This is mainly because I plan to use silence as an important tool to dramatize and emphasize the importance of certain scenes, especially Macy's dialogue, and with no music until the end, when she has her first kill. Colourless's main cinematic qualities lies in the contrasting visuals such as the use of color and no color at all, and how color is a staple of how the story is told through Macy's colorblind eyes. The film's visual inspirations come from Julia Ducournau's Raw, 2016, Dario Argento's Suspiria from 1977, and Andrew Dominik's Blonde from 2022. Celine Sciamma's 2017 hit Portrait of a Lady on Fire, Wes Anderson's The French Dispatch from 2021, and the hit series Stranger Things are also visual inspirations for Colourless. And that is the end of my pitch, Colourless.